Hello everyone, this is Brenniger. Raleigh of Fish Keeping Jamaica asked me to shoot a segment on transforming algae into fish food. Well, the only algae that I culture on purpose is green water. That's the free-floating single-celled organisms, also known as infusoria. And the reason I culture green water is to feed my Daphnia magna, which I culture as fish food. There are two organisms commonly used in algae wafers that are made for Plecostomus, and that are the types of fish that enjoy algae. And both of them are in these omega-1 veggie rounds. One of them, the first ingredient is whole kelp. Now kelp are actually a large type of brown algae. And the second is spirulina. Now spirulina is not actually algae. Spirulina is considered blue-green algae, but it's actually cyanobacteria. Cyanobacteria are related to bacteria, but it's a microorganism that's able to photosynthesize. So it's commonly called blue-green algae, but it's not exactly algae or bacteria. I keep my gallon jar of Daphnia cultures next to the window, and the sunlight does culture some green water for them to consume, not as much during the winter months, but each winter at least some of the Daphnia survive until I can begin culturing green water outdoors again during the warmer months. Some Daphnia incidentally got into this 5-gallon bucket in which I am culturing blackworms. I normally run an air stone on the blackworm culture and keep them alive on brown paper mainly. Occasionally add just a dash of fish food. These Daphnia are thriving on whatever microbes are growing in the blackworm culture. It hasn't been that imperative that I culture green water during the colder months. These Daphnia are thriving in this culture. I usually keep a lid over the 5-gallon bucket loosely to allow oxygen exchange, but to cut down a bit on the evaporation. I put the air stone back on the blackworm and Daphnia culture. A couple of air stones. And the lid holds the airline in place. I'll be able to culture green water during the warmer months in these containers outside. And I like to float a lid in the used aquarium water so that bugs can escape on it, and then I can free them before they die and soil the water. But this year, in addition to used aquarium water and some sort of vegetable like crushed alfalfa pellets, I'd also like to include some sort of fertilizer, because the free-floating algae that compose green water are a plant and they need to be fertilized. This year I'd like to try something different and try and culture some green water in a 10-gallon that I normally use as a quarantine tank. I don't have any fish to quarantine at the moment. So that tank's already set up with a small hang on the back filter and an LED light. I put the light on a separate timer, and I'm going to start with 15 hours of light a day. And I also want to add some of these Osmocote Plus root tabs to fertilize the tank. And to feed the green water, it's not isopropyl alcohol. I formerly had that in this jar. These are alfalfa pellets. So to get them ready for the infusoria to consume, I'm going to mash them up with this mortar and pestle. Here's the 10-gallon quarantine tank that I'm going to try and use to culture green water. Here are the Osmocote root tabs. Here's the alfalfa pellets. And lastly, I'm going to add some fertilizer out of this gallon jar in which I'm keeping plants. Hopefully in several weeks, I'll be culturing infusoria. 24 hours later, the tank is nice and clear. I'd like to point out that infusoria is just a generic term for microbe. Green water contains microbes from the phylum Animalia, like protozoa, which eat bacteria and would make a good first food for the fry of bed of splendens. The green water also contains microbes from the phylum Chlorophyta, and those are the free-floating algae. I'm trying to culture infusoria to feed Daphnia magna, which would eat both algae and protozoa. I'm going to feed my bed of splendens some Daphnia.